Hey everyone! After release in Korea, we all wait for Aion Classic to be released in Western regions. To prepare you for that moment, I have for you today how to pick your class video, because balance of the classes in Aion Classic 1.2 update is very different and might even surprise many of you. Stay with me for the next few minutes to hear which classes are best classes of Aion Classic and which classes can be hard to master and play with. Before we start, let me just say subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that bell icon to see more Aion Classic videos in the future. I am following all informations from beautiful world of Aion, and when I see something interesting is happening or if I see some useful informations, you will see that here on my YouTube channel. So make sure to subscribe. Okay, let's dive into video. And first we will start with warriors. So first class we are going to talk about is Gladiator. It's a close range damage dealing class with lots of AoE skills. It wears plate armor, but you can also wear other types of armor, which is another story. Main weapons are polearm or greatsword, but I have also played Gladiator with dual weapons, sword-dagger combination, or even double maces. So regarding sword-dagger combination, dual wielding increases Gladiator's single target DPS. So sword-dagger combination is really good for Gladiator if we are talking about single target DPS. Regarding double maces, that's a longer story, but in short, mace have very high magical accuracy, and you need magical accuracy because then you have your skill effects to the full capacity, we can say, developed. So double maces, yes, even that combination can go on Gladiator. So in that early days of Aion, we can say in Aion Classic, you can play basically Gladiator with many different kind of weapons. Regarding group gameplay, it's amazing class. As a Gladiator, you will be needed for PvP group gameplay and for PvE group gameplay because of high damage, AoE skills, and also, don't forget, you can tank. If you don't have any Templar in your group, you can be main tank. Also, I forget to mention at the start, regarding the shield, you can wear shield. Regarding one versus one, it's a very good class for PvP against all classes except magical classes, like Sorcerer and Spirit Master. Also, Cleric can be a problem, but then again, Cleric is problem basically in one versus one for every class. Regarding Sorcerer and Spirit Master, as Gladiator, I had lots of problems with that classes. I mean, other classes, one versus one against Templars, Chanters, Assassins, you'll be fine. But against a good Sorcerer and good Spirit Master, you will lose. You need to accept that. And for a while, it was a huge problem for me, because even if you have highly geared Gladiator, you'll still have lots of problems with Sorcerer and Spirit Master. Regarding Gladiator class, you need to know one more important thing. You need extendable weapon. You can get it in Draupnir Cave, but don't forget that you need extendable weapon, because when you get it, when you get that weapon, finally, you'll be stronger like 200%. Without extendable weapon, you can play also Gladiator, but you will feel much less powerful. There is a saying that each Gladiator is good as much as his Cleric is good, and that is true. There are some HP retrieving skills like Absorbing Fury, Draining Sword, but in generally, you will need a healer with you all the time. So you need Pocket Cleric. Yeah, it's kind of funny to say Pocket Cleric, but you need it. So, you as played, I will tell you, Gladiator, it feels absolutely amazing to play. And if you play this class, if you decide to play this class, you will be needed for both, like I said, PvP, PvE, it's amazing class. However, bad sides of this class are that against Sorcerer and Spirit Master, you are zero, nothing. Good Sorcerer and good Spirit Master must kill you. If you win against sorcerer or spirit master, that doesn't mean that you are good Gladi. That means they are bad sorcerer and bad spirit master. Also, regarding healing, yeah, usually you need somebody to follow you all the time, some pocket cleric with you all the time. So Gladiator, truly amazing class in Aion Classic. Let's go forward with next plate armor class, and that is a Templar. Templar is main tank class of Aion Classic. It's a melee class, also where plate armor, like Gladiator, uses a shield. You are main tank, don't forget that. But also you can have nice damage. I will talk a little bit later about damage of Templars, but never say that Templar have low damage. I will tell you later why. Main weapons are swords, mace, greatsword. Same as Gladiator, you will benefit from extendable weapon. Yeah, you need extendable. Regarding group gameplay, for PvE group gameplay, you will be needed a lot to tank. For PvP group gameplay, I have seen some Templars playing as support Templar, that type of Templar, and it was amazing. You will be a leader, and this is really nice way also to play Templar. It's a very good class, one versus one, for PvP against almost all classes. One versus one, I have seen amazing things done by Templars. Whoever say Templar doesn't have damage, he doesn't know what he talk about. Templar can have amazing damage, but it needs to gear up. I have seen Templar destroying one versus one all other classes. It doesn't matter which class you are. One versus one, Templar win. But there is that condition, and you need to understand that. So you need to have your gear on not 100%, not the best gear in game. You need to have your gear on 150%. And maybe Gladiator S class can be stronger than Templar, but in generally, Templar is amazing. All classes need to have good gear, you need to know that, to see the full power of your class. But regarding Templar, you need to have your gear on 150%, even better than that. Other than that, amazing class. However, if you decide to play this class, don't forget, ever don't forget that you need to have gear which is much, much better than normal gear, even best gear in game. You need to have like your gear, even whatever it is possible to develop to the maximum. That's it. Okay, let's go forward. Let's talk about mages. And the first class we are going to talk about here, I will tell you something about a sorcerer. Sorcerer is a ranged magical class, can use a spellbook or orb as weapon. It has insane high damage, but also it's really squishy. It's called glass cannon. And if you play MMORPGs, then you know what that means. Glass cannon, yeah. Very high damage, but very squishy. It wears a cloth armor. Regarding group gameplay, you will be needed for PvE because of high damage. And for PvP, you will also be needed because of high damage and CC skills. Crowd control skills. Sorcerer have amazing CC skills. But bad side in group gameplay, you will be marked as target 1 or maybe target 2 if you have Spirit Master with you in group. Then Spirit Master will be target 1. But normally, Sorcerer, when I play on Gladiator or Templar, when I'm marking, usually Sorcerer is always target number 1. So, yeah, you will probably die first. 1 versus 1, it's a very good class for PvP, especially against plates. As Gladiator, I told you, I had huge problems against Sorcerer. And you will be a little bit weaker against Assassin, but don't worry about that. Assassin class, yeah, they are cloth killers. That's your anti-class. In generally, Sorcerer is amazing one versus one. Gear, that is also interesting part to say. Like I have told you for Templar that you need to have your gear on 150%, where on Sorcerer, you don't need to have that. If you have, let's say, normal gear on 100%, you will be fine, right? That's the difference between Templar and Sorcerer. To fully develop power of your class, on Sorcerer, you don't need to have that gear insanely high. However, on Templar, you do need to have that. So Sorcerer, like I said, it has insane high damage. Usually you will be on the DPS meter in the over there on the top, probably with some Gladiator or maybe Assassin. And if you like to play this kind of glass cannon class, then Sorcerer is a class for you. Another mage, really amazing class, I have to say that right away to you, is a Spirit Master. Overall looking one of the most powerful classes of Aion, of all times, not only Aion Classic. Specific thing for this class is that it can summon and control the spirits formed of natural elements, earth, wind, water and fire. Also, Spirit Master is main debuffing class with lots of damage over time skills. So Spirit Master can kill you only with dots. It's a ranged magical class, can use spellbook or orb as weapon, same as Sorcerer wears cloth armor. Regarding group gameplay, you will be needed for PvP for sure because of fear skill and debuffs. Usually in group gameplay, PvP group which have Spirit Master wins. Usually, not always. And you will be always target number one, mark number one, because it doesn't matter which class you have in group with you, you will be target number one. And don't forget about that, because if you don't want to die first, if you don't want to be target all the time, then Spirit Master is not the class for you. One versus one, one of the best classes absolutely in solo gameplay. Maybe you can, we can say, you can beat any class. Basically, you can beat any class. And I wouldn't go that far that to say that Spirit Master is the best one versus one class, but one of the best for sure. Funny thing, Spirit Master can even play economic war against any other class because you can remove all scrolls from any other character in game. Scrolls are expensive. And for example, I remember when I had put on me like running scroll, attack scroll, all kind of different kind of scrolls which are not cheap, very expensive. And then some Spirit Master come and he just remove all of my scrolls, gone forever. And yeah, it's a huge thing. You're losing lots of Kina. So Spirit Master is truly amazing class, but not easy to play. It's really hard to master gameplay of that class. I have played Spirit Master during the previous years, and it's completely different story from some other classes. It's completely different kind of gameplay. You need to have that special strategies. And if you will be able to master that class, wow, that will be something amazing. You will really enjoy in Spirit Master. Okay, let's go forward with priests. And first we have here, we want to talk here, I want to show you things regarding Cleric. Cleric is main healing class, wears chain armor. Regarding group gameplay, you will be needed for PvE and for PvP because you need to heal your group members. I have seen some cleric to play on DPS setups and they were really good. It's very hard to kill cleric and also you can make damage at the same time. For some period of time I started to play cleric as main class and it was amazing. You can make damage, you can heal, but then I had to quit that class because of only one reason. And this is important to know. If you will be cleric, prepare yourself for all the time people shouting to you, please heal me, please rest me, please heal me, please rest me, please, all the time. It's really bad regarding that. But if you can handle that, you'll be fine. Also, you need to know when your group win, group where you play as cleric, everyone will say it's because of some nice gameplay of damage classes in your group. But if your group lose, everyone will blame cleric. It's always like that. It's always cleric's fault. That's true. So if you win, your group wins, nobody will say that's because of cleric. But if you lose, yeah, it's your fault for sure. And that other thing, right? That first thing which I said, that's why I quit playing cleric. Please heal me, please rest me, please, all day, all night, all the time when you play Aion, that's, I couldn't handle that. If you can handle that, Great, then Cleric is class for you. It's amazing class in 1v1. Also, I have to say that I have seen many duels Cleric against other classes. Cleric is very, very hard to kill for any class. You need to have that burst damage to kill it really fast. Otherwise, it will heal yourself. And that's it. And also, it can make damage. I told you, some clerics were playing on DPS setups and still they can heal themselves and make damage. So, amazing. Solo gameplay in generally, cleric can do some things which no other class can do, because you can heal yourself. So there are some world bosses, I will say mini bosses, which you can kill solo. Not bosses, mini bosses, which you can kill solo, but other classes can't. So cleric, truly amazing class. If you decide to play this class, don't forget, it's a healing class. And like I said, if you can handle this thing regarding heal me please, rest me please, you will be just fine. Another priest, I must say, really amazing, it's Chanter. And Chanter, I could talk about Chanter for 1 hour. It's so much powerful class. It's one of the most powerful classes of Aion in generally. Wears chain armor, it's a support class, but not only that. It can also be amazing in PvP. Damage of this class in PvE in general is not so high. So if you are looking high damage class regarding PvE, Chanter is not class for you. But Chanter have other things which other classes don't have, and in PvP, like I said, it's absolutely amazing. Regarding group gameplay, you will be needed a lot for both PvE and for PvP because of your buffs and mantras. In solo gameplay, 1v1, it's a really amazing class against basically any class. And that is the secret of the Chanter. Chanter can be anti-class for every class. It can fight really amazing against, doesn't matter which class. There is no any kind of magical class or plate or whatever. I would say it's really good against Chanter. Chanter is, we can say, good to fight with against any class. I have seen some duels and participate in duels where Chanters were destroying all other classes. Also, yeah, you need to have gear, really good gear, and you need to know how to play your class. I have played a long time Chanter as main class, actually about a year or two, so decent amount of time. And it's a really powerful class, but for me, it has one kind of fault, we can say, not a good thing. It was not aggressive enough to play with it. For example, when I play Gladiator, I need to play it on aggressive way. It's that kind of class. But Chanter, you can't play like that. Chanter, you need to play on more strategic way, more calm way. And I didn't like that. So Chanter in general is absolutely amazing class, powerful class. But you need to play it a little bit less aggressive, and then you will enjoy in that class. Okay, let's check what we have left here. We have scouts, and first I will tell you something about assassins. Assassins are one of the highest DPS classes of Aion Classic. Close range class, leather armor with amazing burst of DPS in PvP and PvE. Uses daggers and sword as weapon and have stealth abilities. So regarding this damage thing, you will usually be on the top of DPS meter, probably with some gladiator or sorcerer. Regarding group gameplay, you will be needed for PvE because of high damage, and for PvP also for same reason. It's a very good class for PvP 1v1 against mages. Assassins are cloth killers. Don't forget that. So, Sorcerer, Spirit Master, yeah, this is really amazing to fight with Assassin. However, you will be weaker against plates like Gladiator and Templars. As Gladiator, I just needed to survive against Assassin 1v1. If I play Gladi, I know that I need to survive that first burst for a few seconds. Then I know I will be fine and I will win. I will win that fight for sure. Only if I can survive that first burst of assassin damage. So Assasin, I must say, it's really amazing class. And if you enjoy to play this kind of classes in MMORPG games, yes, Assassin in Aion Classic is, we can say, one classic Assassin class in MMORPG game. And the last class here before conclusion I have for you on the end, a few sentences really important to know about Aion Classic. But before that, let me tell you a few things regarding Ranger. So Ranger is a ranged physical damage class, uses bow as weapon and wears leather armor. This is a DPS class. Make no mistake, this is DPS class. Regarding group gameplay, you'll be needed for PvE and for PvP because of your damage. It's a very good class for PvP in generally, for solo and for group gameplay, but it's pretty squishy. I have seen in group PvP highly geared rangers dying really fast. So big difference between Assassin and Ranger, I would say, is that Assassin, you cannot kill that fast. However, Ranger, you can. So don't forget about that regarding Ranger. So on the end of this video, I want to tell you something really important. So each one of these classes is amazing on its own unique way. But you need to know one important thing. Aion is a game in which power of your character depends on the quality of your gear. If you have best gear in game, any class you play on decent way can be amazing. Don't underestimate classes like Templar or Chanter, because those two classes, if you have best possible gear in game and played correctly, can be stronger than any other class. Yes, Templar and Chanters. I don't know how many times I received whisper, can you please help me? I can't play with my Templar or Chanter is so weak. Then I don't know really what to say. Those classes are amazing. Classes like Gladiator, Sorcerer and Spirit Master are always good to play. And you will have lots of fun with them. I promise you that. Also, Cleric, Assassin and Ranger have their own spot in most of group gameplay for PvP and PvE. But also you can play solo with them a lot. That's important to know. There is no bad class in Aion. There is only bad gear, or maybe some class just don't fit your playstyle. So whichever class you pick, gear up to maximum and you will feel true power of your character in PvP and PvE. Tell me in the comments below video, which is your favorite class and why? Which class you will play when we get Aion Classic released in Western regions? Thank you for watching the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel to see more Aion Classic videos in the future. See you soon!